heard some of the things that happen in Ubers. Like, I just know some of the conversations I've had in Ubers are fucked.
Right.
And you just like...
I mean, it's always like... It's like you hear these stories about people fishing condoms out of themselves. It's like... Look at you jaywalking. What is this?
I know. Find me.
Taking you to Elmerite?
Yeah.
No. It's leaving. The Uber's leaving now. It's flashing red on pedestrians.
I know, I know.
Just
I think
run
this
someone
is,
over who cares.
I mean, like, it'd make a good story. The story. Everyone has one, and I like hearing them, but there's just one this week, which is just kind of... I don't know. You'll see. Enjoy.
There's some dude on the internet that was like playing games and slept with him once. And
no, actually I don't want to do that.
But there is a YouTube video of some guy talking about having sex with me and it's an interesting time.
Are you serious? Like was he like upset because it didn't work out sort of thing or?
Oh well he was a bit older than me, so he was super worried, like not super older. Tried to shave down there and ended up like cutting his dick, and then he's like, oh, I gotta wear a condom, and then like his dick was, anyways, the condom came off in me.
Okay.
And then I had, it was a horrible experience.
Well, I feel like you're missing out a lot of that story. Yeah, I really didn't expect it to go there, but like, apparently it has, so I feel... I feel like you're obliged to let us know what the hell. That information was kind of just thrown at us all at once, so over the course of the episode, inch by inch, we're going to try to get a little bit more information about what happened to her and this guy. So, I have questions.
Yeah.
So you stopped seeing him after he put the video up or after the bad sexual experience?
After the bad sexual experience.
Do you want to? Okay. You gotta remember that I'm pretty much in a customer service role here, so there are a lot of questions in my head, but I had to build a little bit of rapport before I could, you know, ask those questions. More on that in a second, but, you know, a comedian once said that a relationship is when everything's going well. Otherwise, you're in a relationship.
There was a stag do, and they asked if I'd do the stag's makeup.
Oh, yeah,
and
no,
I was like,
tell me this.
I was like, oh, I'd love to, that'd be so funny. So as I was doing his makeup, he thought he was a prostitute. And he was like, he slapped me and was like, oh, you and me are going to have fun tonight. I was like, I don't think you understand who I am. I was like, oh, no, I think I do.
I'm very curious, though, as to, like, your story went from he was shaving and he cut his dick to the condom fell off in me. And I was like...
In me.
But how, what does that have to do? What does that have to do with him cutting his dick? Or is it just... Are they separate and it's kind of...
I mean, they're separate things, but, like, they both also happened in the one experience.
Wait, he shaved in front of you?
And I was, like, trying to deflect from the awkwardness, like, oh, so what's... So how long have you and your fiancé been together? You went, oh, too long.
Oh, great.
I was like, oh, the lovely...
Would have vomited right there and then.
I was like, what a lucky girl.
The worst.
Because I had sex with him and then the condom came off in me and I'm like, well, this has never happened to me before.
So he was wearing a condom that was too big for him?
Probably, yeah. Anyway, so to fish it out of me.
We're definitely getting on the video.
Just throwing out there to the audience. You don't mean that. No, you've watched too much Mean Girls. You've watched too much.
Were you the one who said we should hit somebody, like a pedestrian?
Yeah, okay.
That's twice in like
2 minutes. He lives around the corner. We could go by.
These things happen. I mean, the poor guy is probably like watching too much TV and thinking he's got to buy like extra
large. Get your back, buddy! She's going through a bad breakup.
Fair enough.
Cars have been coming up a lot in conversation.
Fair enough.
If we
got to make a detour, I understand.
Can we to Alpha?
We got a golf club in the boot.
I mean,
oh, yes!
I'm kidding.
I'll just say,
Jesus.
If it's a 5-star rating you're after, you've got it. Like,
it's oh more just random.
Oh my God, I wish I heard some of the things that happened in Uber. Like, I just know some of the conversations I've had in Ubers are fucked.
Right.
And you just, like...
I mean, it's always, like... It's like you hear these stories about people fishing condoms out of themselves. It's like...
This would make the best podcast of all time.
I may as well actually ask you guys, because, like, this is a security camera. It's, like, always rolling. But it's such a no pressure. I do have a YouTube channel where I put up, like, fun compilations.
Oh, shit.
But it's totally, like, if you want to be in it, it's so no pressure. So if you want to, like, just a normal Uber ride.
You picked up my friends the other night.
And they say romance is dead.
I would, you know, before you try to have sex with someone, choose the right condom size for yourself, you know? Just really go through the pros and cons of each size, like, does this really fit
What
me?
If he was just cold? Because, you know, it shrinks when you're cold.
Yeah, I know, but you would be hoping that...
I don't think
that
it would be cold if it was inserted in somewhere.
And you'd be hoping that, like, we were, like, doing stuff enough that it wouldn't be cold. You know, like, I feel like, you know...
Oh, I hear you. Don't worry.
As if I can't wait to tell the girls I got you too. I'd like to thank my fans for all their support.
Mum and Dad, I love you.
Well done.
Hello everybody.
Well done.
On your next trip.
Well done. See ya.
Thanks,
bye.
So it was a weird situation because he just like stopped. And then he was like, he said something about my housemates. I'm like, why the fuck are you talking about my housemates? Like your dick, like I'm assuming is still inside me. He didn't have a very big dick.
That's what I'm gathering.
It was a
I
sad
was reading between
time, guys.
Now hold on. I think this whole video has been about how guys are the worst in the dating game, but I feel like we need some fresh perspective.
We just need to do a quick stop of home to drop this box of beer off.
Sure thing.
And then we're going out.
Good on you. No worries.
Sorry, man.
You're all good. All right. Two blokey Aussies. Let's see if they can redeem the male reputation.
So many female friends of gay guys that are single and ready to mingle.
Very attractive as well.
Really? Okay.
And they are
you're
ready.
Blowing my mind.
They are ready for it. So you go to Sunday Love Mac and you will take one lucky lady home.
But in saying that, even some guys that have, like, you know, it doesn't have to be a disappointment. Some people just know how to use it for the, you know, whatever.
It's
absolutely fine.
Yeah, exactly right.
Just didn't.
Yeah. Just gotta have game. Is a fun night.
You gotta have game.
Everyone's super chilled. Everyone's super happy.
You're such good value. I've gotta give it to you.
You didn't finish the story, so he
and there's more.
He stopped, asked you about your housemates, and then what happened? Then you had to just randomly fish a condom.
Or like, was that foreplay talk? As in, like, you were getting into it and it's like, let me tell you about your housemates.
When we didn't work on Monday, when we used to hit up Love Mac every single weekend, brother, that shit was sick. But now, reality check, we're fucking got careers and shit.
Work.
Fuck my life, I'm such a loser.
Was this one of the first times you guys had sex?
Yeah, no, literally the first time.
Have you heard of polite sex?
No.
So polite sex is pretty much like the first couple of times you have sex with someone and you're trying your hardest to just be natural, but you're like trying way too hard and it comes off as awkward, clumsy and like awful. And it's super it's super common.
No, I would explain it as that.
So you were having polite sex and the this happened. If you've ever had polite sex and you've got the balls to admit it, comment polite sex below and extra points if you've got a good story for me. Where'd you meet him?
Tinder.
Fair. And you know what, like, the pressure's on him, right? Because he matches with like a pretty girl and then he has to... I wasn't complimenting you, but you totally... like, I feel like that's all you heard, so now the rest of whatever...
Hey, I like the attention. So, let's not get bogged down in that. That's fine. I'm just... You call me pretty, it's fine. Let's keep going.
You see this praying mantis in the car?
Tommy,
there's a fucking...
Oi, bro! Oi, I got chased by a fucking praying mantis at my fucking house the other night. I will link you.
She's gonna kill you.
That's terrifying.
I don't want to be a woman.
Yeah.
I don't want to have to be fishing things out of there for the rest of my life.
I gotta get this praying mantis out here. This thing's massive.
Oi, those things bite. Oi,
do they bite?
Oi. Ooh. Oi, I'll dead set leg it.
I don't think they can, man. You were a great Uber driver, but I'm out of here, bro.
See you guys. Have a good night.
Hey, what's your Facebook, man?
Oh my god.
Nice to meet you.
You're learning something tonight.
That's amazing. Oh my god, is it recording? Okay, thank god.
My mom's gonna be so proud.
Darren.
L-E-B-Y.
L-E-B-Y.
See you, buddy.
Let's talk about carpentry more often, brother.
Later. So nice to meet you guys.
It was so lovely to meet you too. Thank you so much. Bye, you too. Yeah.
You need your bag.
Oh, yeah. See ya. Bye.